What's happening, John Lund, guys? Welcome back to Assassin's Creed 2. This is Chapter 9, and when we last left off, I did some off-screening, and a lot has changed. So I don't know if it's prevalent or not. I don't really notice. Well, I notice what's different, and I know this place has changed a bit. I don't know if the rest of the town has really changed much. If it has, you guys will obviously see it here, but I don't think it will until we upgrade every shop fully. Any case, though, I've done a lot off-screen. I'm going to get into that, but pretty much I've bought a bunch of buildings and stuff. Like, I've gotten all the renovations done now, and as for the shops, I'm currently working on that. I have two fully done, and then I have another three to go still. One's at level one, and the other's at level two, I believe. In any case, from here, you can see, like, that tower right directly in front of me, where the hood is. That's the Thieves Guild. That one right there is the courtesans building, and then that one is the barracks. And then we have the church as well, which I'm going to go through all that. The church is right there. The well, which you kind of can't see from here. So jump down, but there's a well over here. And pretty much the only thing with the well, well, with most of these buildings, the only reason to get it was to get the treasure chests. But the well, all it does is it goes down in this little, I'll show you guys real quick. Goes down into this little, like, cavern area, and then it made me kind of do this little gauntlet. Not even gauntlet, just, like, a little challenge map to get across. So I had to, you know, come across and then go all the way over and then come down onto this platform over there, like, that pole that's over there. And then I had to basically figure my way across this room because you can't get up on the other side. There's a ladder here in case you fall, but on the other side there's no ladder there, so I had to hardcore parkour all the way over to get those chests. Same thing with the mine that's out back, which, like, again, I'll cover all this in a second. It was just basically a little area, cavern, where, you know, I could do some hardcore parkour to find the chests. So I figured I'm going to go through everything pretty much here, which is probably going to take about 20 minutes or so, and then we'll jump back into the action with the story game. With the story mission, at which point, when I'm done explaining and exploring and showing off everything, I'll probably have a drop to pick up, so then I can pick something up, do a renovation on screen, and then we'll go from there. So like I said, the will was one of the additions, one of the renovations, which upped the city's, I don't know what to call it, upped the city's value. Obviously, the walls are still looking a little, you know, eh. And like I said, the buildings do too, but I think that will all get improved once I improve the, all the shops. Because, like I said, once I finished all the renovations, I noticed that the building itself improved. So anyways, there's these statues around. I think I picked up one off-screen. Any case, though, what they were I had to go around collecting them and find the corresponding counterpart to it. So this one's the Mars and Venus statuettes. The god of rage and strength basks in his lover's radiant beauty. She tames his anger with her gentle touch. It's basically when I found both of them, I put them on the pedestal, and the pedestal opened up, and it gave me 2,000 florins. I did this another three times, and so I got a total of 8,000 florins just by finding these statues. They weren't really well hidden. They were around. I mean, they're easy to miss, but if you looked around, you could find them. I didn't have to use a guide. It only took me about maybe 10 minutes to find them. I didn't straight up look for them, too. I just kind of found them when I was looking for the chests and stuff, but but yeah. So I thought I'll show you guys these real quick. And then I'll show you the inside, what we have going on so far. Because I never really showed off the inside of this mansion yet. I didn't really explore it on screen. I explored it off screen. So we'll take a look at the building, like I said, and then go through the renovations and changes I made, and then we'll go from there. So, if we head to the left instead of going to the right, this first room is a weapons armory. So any weapon I buy will actually permanently be here, and then I can switch between weapons. So we have the common sword, which was just kind of given to us at the start of the game there. Never had to buy that. I've bought, obviously, the Ventian Falchion, just because that was the one I bought on screen. And then I have this dagger and a knife. And I believe that's it for weapons. What was that? 1, 2, 3, 4? Yeah. The next room beside it is the armory. Same thing. You can switch through armors here and whatnot. So this one is the leather armor set. So I have the Spalders, the chest guard, and the greaves. I'm missing one thing, which I'm going to assume is bracers. And then for the Helmschmied armor, I just have the greaves for now, which I'm actually wearing those greaves currently. So these ones normally wouldn't be black like that. You would see the color of it, like, or the detail of it, like the greaves are. But because I'm wearing it, that's why they're black. That's how you can tell which ones you have equipped and stuff. Here's just the backyard and stuff. Here's his, I want to say his study, more or less. And there's actually a puzzle to go with this. So pretty much, once we find all the pieces, we can come over, hit interact, use eagle vision, and then try to figure out what this map pertains to. I'm not even going to try to start to solve that right now because I don't have all the pieces, so it's going to be kind of pointless, but there it is there. The chest box back here, obviously, you know what that's for. It's just for collecting our money. We can either talk to Claudia or go straight to the chest box.
Salute, Claudia.
You here to look at the book?
It's easier to just go straight to the chest box because you save about 30 seconds or so rather than going through this. I'll go through this right now, though. So the town's value is already up to 58,140 florins, and that means our chest income is 5,813 florins every 20 minutes. Move the cursor off screen here. There's a breakdown of it, so the shops, what the shops are worth, the renovations, and then collections equipment. So I'm about 38% complete. I don't know, well, obviously that has to count for collections too, so it's going to take a while, but the core of like upgrading this place itself is almost done. So here, the art merchant's at level 1, bank is level 2, blacksmith level 1, doctor and tailor are both level 3. I got a bonus for all shops being open, so that's an extra 5,000 value, and then all shops at level 3, I'll get another bonus. The numbers beside it, so the numbers right here, are just the value that totals up here. So basically, like, having the art merchant is worth 750 florins, having the bank at level 2 is 6,500. Taylor at level 3 is 6,500, so on and so forth. Renovations. I have all the renovations, so they're all there. Brothel, mines, church, military barracks, thieves guild, and well. And then having them all completed gives me an extra 10,000 value of florins, worth of florins, rather. Here's the collection screen. This shouldn't change that much. Codex pages, still 9. Feathers is 5. Models, none. Seals, none. Paintings, none yet. Portraits of the targets we've killed. We have 2 so far. I'll go over that in a second. So obviously, all the extra bonuses from that are locked, because that's, I'm probably not going to get that until about halfway through the game or so. Equipment, I'll probably get a little bit sooner, but we still have a ways to go. So I have 4 of the 22 weapons, 3 of the 4 leather armor, 1 of 4 Helmschmied armor, and then none of the other armor. Looks like we can get the armor of Altair, which is pretty cool. And then chests. So the villa currently generates an income of 5,813 florins every 20 minutes. It can hold a maximum of 23,255 florins. So it means if we're out and about playing, recording and whatnot, and, you know, because I'm going to be making money while we record. If I'm in missions and I can't get back here, I have, let's say 5,000, 10, 15. So I have pretty much an hour and 20 minutes to get back here before it will fill up, and then it's just wasting money on top of that. So here's the architect.
Salute, Serezio. Shall we take a look at the list?
It's going to be the exact same thing I basically showed through the books, but I'll go in more in depth. So the art merchant, like I said, is level 1. The next upgrade is 5,000 florins and gets me 10% off. The bank is level 2. Basically, it just increases value, but it increases the value a lot more than the other shops. So it's definitely something you'd probably want to upgrade first. Blacksmith is only level 1. Doctor and tailor are both level 3, so I get 15% off both of those shops. The doctor is not really that big of a deal. Tailor is kind of nice, though. Brothel has been renovated, so it's in the corner on the right side of the gate if you're in the city. The mines is at the back of the city, and like I said, the only thing that goes on with the mines is the same thing as the well. It was a little area where I maneuvered and got a couple chests. Church, just a small building. There was a couple chests in there. There's the military barracks there. Thieves Guild over there. And the well there. So I have 5 more upgrades. 5 more upgrades I gotta go for. That's not too bad. So up top here, we really don't have a whole lot. The balcony on either side here, as you can see. Coming through here is just above his study. I'll go up here first, actually. I don't really know what this place is, per se. I kind of want to say it's our study, just because it would make the most sense, but I'm not entirely sure. Any case, we have the portraits of the people we killed here. So here's Uberto Alberta. And then here is Vary de Peachy. De Patsy, whatever it was. And then if you look around... Oh, no, not yet. I was going to say... Well, you can kind of... There's a painting or a canvas. Fuck, what are they called? Is it canvas? It's not canvas. Easel. One here. At least. So you know there's at least one more, but obviously... I haven't showed it off yet, but if I click the start menu and go into conspirators, I have a whole list here. So there's two gone. One, two, three, four. Another five showing at least. So I'm probably going to have at least another five. The game's actually not telling me how many targets I'm going to have yet, which I like. I think that's, you know, decent enough. Here's our mother's room. The only thing to do here is just to put the feathers in the chest. I think you get a cape when you collect all of 100, if I remember correctly. Not that I've done it, but... Then, I'm not sure if paintings go out here or not. I would reckon so. I know the paintings go in here for sure, and then when you have them, you can go to it and look at it. And then down there is just the armor. So that's pretty much the mansion here. An overview of everything we've done. Like I said, I did a lot off-screen. Between the finding all the chests, which got me a fair bit of money. Finding the statues, which got me 8,000. And then just... leaving the game running. Like, I've had the game running for a while. I think if I look at the time, I'm over, like, probably about 9 hours now that I've quote-unquote played in game, but really it's only been, what is this, chapter 9 2 4 6 8, so really it's only been a little more than 4 hours. And that guy had freaking skeleton legs. Look at that. Oh my goodness. Just last month the Visconti bought. Just want to see if there's anything new here. So there's still the Warhammer and the Syrian sword. That's yes. It. I only serve the elite. I was only the still have the pouches I have to collect from this guy. Now I'm not sure if I skip medium pouch, if I just go to large pouch, or if I get medium pouch and the large pouch will come down in price. Probably not. Probably gonna switch to the Tuscan Ember when I have Florian's to spare.
Of course, I understand.
The art guy here actually has paintings to sell now. I don't know if we actually ever looked at them. That's for the treasure maps. Obviously, I bought the treasure map for this area.
I understand. So. I'll have more. I have tradition.
And then for the doctor, I can heal myself now or just buy medicine, so which I'm actually full up
perhaps
on.
Another day.
All right, so without further ado, I don't really have much more to do right now, so we might as well go talk to Mario and see what the next assignment... idea, whatever he wants, pertains to. Not necessarily going to wait around for the next Florian deposit, but if it happens to happen before we leave, then I'll do the renovation. If not, I'm sure we'll get it before the end of the video. We still have tons of time. So.
Ezio, my boy, I think it's time I showed you something.
Of course, there's a secret in this place. Jesus. Alright, I guess I'll run down after you. What is this?
This is the sanctuary. It was built by my great-grandfather to honor the memory of the Assassin Order and protect its secrets. Look around. These are the assassins who guarded the freedom of humanity when it was most threatened. And this is the armor of Altair. Little is known about Altair's life, but his armor is light and very strong. I give it to you, but I don't know how to retrieve it. My great-grandfather told me it would remain locked away until all its protectors were made whole. I heard rumors of crypts located throughout Italia, hidden tombs filled with treasure, where these six were moved centuries ago. Maybe they have something to do with it. In my younger days, I sought the six myself, with no success. Perhaps you will have better luck.
Well, I'm down for it. I'll go crypt
diving. In order to achieve perfect synchronization with Ezio, you have to get that armor.
Some nice looking armor too, Jesus. Altair's armor lays behind the gate. The gate is fitted with 6 locks. Wei Yu. That name sounds very familiar. Darius. Kulan Gal. Hopefully I didn't butcher that. Probably Quailon. Amunet. Altani. Leonis. In any case. Apparently I'm heading back to Florence. Perhaps to the first crypt. Just gonna check the box before we leave just to see if it had got deposited and maybe I mixed it. I doubt it though. Kind of been paying attention. Yeah. Watch, I'm gonna get all the way to the front gate and then it's gonna be deposited. But like I said, I mean, I have up to an hour and, well, I mean, it deposits it every 20 minutes. So I have 80 minutes before it fills up and then I have another 20 minutes on top of that. So really I have an hour and 40 minutes before I start wasting money away. Go collect the horse. Not sure if the fast travels work yet. And even if they do, I'm not sure if I'm going straight into Florence or not. So we might as well just ride there. And you know what? I'm going the wrong way. I kind of want to go back to the other one, Tuscany or whatever it is, but I'll just head in whichever way the game directs me. Yes, I'm sure I want to go to Florence. Look at that picture there. That guy got impaled so bad. Repubblica Florentina, 1478. Such a beautiful city. Oh, I'm like right in the city, okay. Ah, I gotta talk to Leonardo. Gotcha. Well, let's head over there to that viewpoint, I suppose. Excuse me. Yeah. Chances are it's gonna make me go into this district. So if I'm gonna go in this district, I might as well get the viewpoints ready. That way I can actually see where I'm going. That archer right there. He won't see nothing. I'll have to check all the shops here once I actually have money to spend. I'm not going to be spending any cash until I do all the upgrades in the town there. Out of my way before I throw you into something. But yeah, no, I'm not going to spend any extra money until I get all the upgrades in the town there because it just makes logical sense. I mean, you want to capitalize on the profit that you can make, right? And I mean, you can't make profit if you don't put the money in to spend. Get out of here. I got to get up there. Feather.
He's there on him.
Funny how he didn't die.
Eccolo, hurry, get him.
Hmm. How am I gonna get to this one? There has to be, like, some way to climb it on one of these sides, obviously. Or not. That's cool, too. Well, backup strat. This isn't gonna work. Ooh, it did. Nice. Make sure there's nothing up here, because it's gonna be a pain in the ass to get back to if I need to. Or if I want to, rather. Ooh, another codex page. Let's go for that codex page on the way to the next viewpoint. '16 of '73. We're getting there slowly. Side of this building. Yeah, it is. Just sucks because there's a group of guards right there. And it sucks because I don't have my drop assassination either. If I did, I could just kill that guy right now.
Not you!
Any last words?
Tough guys. Nice. I don't know what that is running over there. Yeah. Shouldn't really let him get away. Probably raises my notoriety, but that's fine. Codex page acquired. Let me guess. That is the official, right? Pickpocket. Let's see if I can't catch him. Oh, I disappeared already. Wonder if he actually pickpocketed us then. He probably did. To that viewpoint, and there's a wanted poster right there anyways. Actually, there's one down here.
Right there. Bizarre.
Okay.
What's with him?
Well, we got it in any case, so... You gotta be kidding me. I should have been able to grab that. It was just a little bit out of reach. I didn't think I was gonna jump that far over anyways. I thought I'd be able to jump and land on that. That's where I wanna go. It's fine though. Funny, because I completely forgot that money gets deposited into the chest there. So I looked down at my money real quick, and I'm like, well, why the hell do I only have this much? And I remembered. Just because I'm going to have to buy the treasure map. Well, I don't have to. I'm going to want to buy the treasure map here, obviously, so I can get all the treasure. I'm not going to do that on screen. I'll do that off screen, but... That's what I wanted to do earlier. Just kind of screwed up my jump. So I'm probably heading to that place right in front of me. Another pickpocket all the way over there. Surprised there's not a feather all the way up there. Not that I can see anyways. And before there is one up there, and you know, I'll have to backtrack for it. Map updated. If I can make my way back over there.